His works come through the river of the Spirit. John 14, verse 17. The Spirit of truth whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees Him nor knows Him, but you know Him, for He dwells with you and will be in you. We are examining the 14th chapter of John, where Jesus told us that we who believe in Him, the works He did, we will do, and greater works than those we will do because He went to the Father. And we are trying to understand the keys that Jesus disclosed right after that, making that statement, that will enable us to do the works He did and even greater works. So this week, we've been considering the verses He gave, the statements He made, because I go to the Father, which means that the works He did, we will do because of His death. The work He finished on the cross, His resurrection and His exaltation. He said, in His name, we will do it. Then He said, out of love and obedience will come forth the works. And then He said, my Spirit would abide with you. But then He went on to say something more. He said, you will know Him because He not only is with you, but He will be in you. This is something even further. He says, the Holy Spirit is going to be in you. Can you imagine? You are now a person in whom the mighty Spirit of God dwells. And now you're going to know Him because He's dwelling with you and in you. Now, His indwelling presence is the Holy Spirit filling us, being in us, means that He is there in us to flow out of us. Jesus made this very clear in John 7, 37 to 29. He said, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. So you come to Jesus, you're drinking, you're receiving something into you. And then He said, right after that, he who believes in me, out of his innermost being will flow rivers of living water. So you're drinking something, you're taking in out of your relationship with Jesus. But then out of your innermost being will flow the rivers of the Spirit of God. The rivers representing the life and the power of the Spirit being released through you. And the Bible makes it very clear in verse 39 that that's what He's referring to. He's referring to the flow of the Holy Spirit. So putting this back in context in John 14, verse 17, Jesus is saying, you see, when the Holy Spirit comes, He's going to be in you and He's going to flow out through you and you will know Him. So this is talking to us about the release of the power of the Spirit through the life of the believer. We will do the works that Jesus did because the Holy Spirit is going to flow out of us like mighty rivers. It's not our ability. There's nothing of us in ourselves that is going to cause those works to be done. Of course, we cannot do it on our own. But the Holy Spirit flowing out of us like mighty rivers will cause those works to take place. But it also means that we must know Him. We must know how the Holy Spirit flows. We must know how the river of the Spirit is released through our lives. You see, many of us have the river in us, but we don't know how to release Him. We don't know how to open up the dams or let the river flow. What's the use then? All we've got is we've got the Holy Spirit dammed up inside, so to speak. He's been locked up inside of us. He's waiting to come out. He's waiting to flow. He's waiting to be released. But we've quenched the work of the Spirit. We don't know how to release Him. But we must know Him. You must learn how to release the rivers of the Spirit through our lives. Let us as believers desire to do the works He did and even greater works so that we can authenticate and we can confirm Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, who is exalted at the Father's right hand. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we ask that You'll help us learn how to release the flow of the Holy Spirit. Help us to learn how the Holy Spirit seeks to manifest Himself through us, how He desires to express His presence and power through us, and help us to flow with Him so that the works Jesus did will be done through us, and even greater works. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.